but for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Our talent is unrivaled, Your Grace. Forrester Ironwood is highly sought after in the Seven Kingdoms.
So I'm told. It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
I won't dishonor myself, Your Grace.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
She was just following her heart, Your Grace.
And the very same heart so quickly led her to my son.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question.
Go on.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl, but not very encouraging either. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
These are trying times, my lord. My family fears what might happen now that the Boltons rule the North.
They must still answer to the crown. You shouldn't forget that, nor should they. That certainly took courage, to so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Margaery was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I did it for Lady Margaery.
Rather odd, if that's what she asked of you. But I'm sure she has your best interests at heart. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your Ironwood to another house. It is the Master of Coin who decides such matters. The Crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the Crown in this regard, not her.
You can help my family.
I suppose the Crown could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you? I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. 3 beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Mira, I was worried. How was it?
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. I'd rather not discuss it, if you don't mind.
Of course not. It must have been horrible. But at least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the 4th cousins and the 9th-born sons. Ah, Sir Jamie. I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour.
Put it back.
We're just having a bit of fun. That's probably for the best. I've heard he's a bit perverse. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
I'd marry anyone if it helped my family.
Right. Of course. Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the 7 Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly. Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her. Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but My mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise. But my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady. King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa.
It is that dire, my lady. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
Don't let the Queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Margaery, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Seven elves. Let's play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat? Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There. Hear that? I know I heard something. Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.